Good morning, students. Already we have started how do organism reproduce. Now in that we have done difference between sexual and asexual reproduction, advantages of sexual reproduction. Then after that we have done types of asexual reproduction, budding, fragmentation, regeneration, vegetative propagation, multiple fission, binary fission, all these, and we have taken the examples also. And after that we have done advantages and disadvantages of vegetative propagation. These were all asexual reproduction. And after that in next session we have completed sexual reproduction in flowering plants, in that double fertilization, post-fertilization changes, pre-fertilization changes we have done. Now, in this session, we are going to start reproduction in human beings. See, reproduction in human beings is a type of asexual reproduction. In that, we are going to first study different reproductive organs, male reproductive organs, as well as female reproductive organs. Okay, clear? Now, different female organs which participate in reproduction are, first is ovaries. Okay, pair of ovaries are present. Next is oviduct. Next, uterus. Okay, after that vagina, and then external genitalia. Clear? These all the other organs of female reproductive system which participate. Now one by one we are going to study each organ, mainly ovaries, oviduct and uterus. And what will be the process? First, again here, what will be we are going to study? In that we are going to study pre-fertilization changes, pre-fertilization changes taking place in female body, okay, and after that post-fertilization changes taking place, and again in that one option is there that what will happen. These are the conditions which is taking place before fertilization and after fertilization. Now in same we are going to consider what will happen if fertilization does not occur. Okay, and after that we are going to study different male reproductive organs like testes, where it is present, what is the function of testes, different hormones secreted by testes and ovaries, what are their functions, okay, and after that it is epididymis, vas deferens, seminal vesicle, then prostate gland, and Cowper's gland. Yeah, and last is penis. Now, one by one, we are going to consider all these different organs, its function, and mainly, see some of the board exam also. Like, what is the function of seminal vesicle? What is the function of prostate gland? Then, why testis is present in the scrotum? Okay, so these are the important questions. Now, what is the term which is related with this human reproductive system? What is ovulation, fertilization? What is menstruation? Okay, how it occurs? All these topics we are going to consider in human reproduction. And after that, we are going to see reproductive health. Okay, what are the precautions should be taken, and what are the different sexually transmitted diseases? That is a different topic. One more thing, once we are starting human reproduction, the first stage is, that is, changes taking place in boys and girls at the age of puberty. Changes, why it is taking place. So students, let us start with the puberty. What is puberty? What are the different changes taking place in boys and girls at the age of puberty? What do you mean by adolescence? Already these words you are familiar with, all these. Okay, so what are the different changes and why does these changes takes place in boys and girls? So, simple term. First thing, what do you mean by puberty? See, puberty is the time period during which there is secretion of sex hormone and there are certain changes which is taking place at the time of puberty. Okay? And that changes is due to the secretion of sex hormone. So, what does it see? First thing will be, there are changes in boys and girls at teenage. Okay? And what else takes place at this age? There is secretion of sex hormones. Clear? And due to this secretion, there are certain changes in boys and girls. Okay? Like skin becomes oily. Okay? What are the changes? Skin becomes oily, pimples, and production of hair. Hair growth takes place in some of the parts of the body. Then voice becomes, there is change in voice. You can observe also, there are some changes in, even mostly you must have seen in boys, there are many changes, and it becomes it becomes louder and heavier in boys. Okay, so these changes are taking place in boys. Mustache and beard starts appearing in boys, and in girls, menstruation starts, and there is changes in the structure. Hair growth. Again, if we are, these are the physical changes which we can see. There are some changes in the behavior also. So both changes are taking place, physical changes also and behavioral changes also. Okay, so at the time of puberty, there are physical changes in boys and girls, and along with that, behavioral changes also. Many times it happens when our elders are suggesting something. What happens? The teenagers, they get irritated. Why? They think that they are well capable of deciding each and everything. That is due to the secretion of these hormones also. Next thing, due to this secretion, there is development of secondary sexual character. Okay? In boys, or we can say in male, there is secretion of testosterone, while in female, there is secretion of progesterone and estrogen. Okay, these are the hormones which control secondary sexual character in males and females. In boys and girls, changes start to appear at teenage. Just now I've told you that, and that is due to the secretion of sex hormone from testes and ovaries. This time period of changes is known as puberty. And changes also indicates menstruation and all. See, some common changes in boys and girls are: skin become oily and pimples may begin to develop. Voice begins to change. In boys, mustache and beard starts to appear. And sexual maturation of the body starts. This maturation in girls starts at 10 to 12 years, and in boys it starts at the age of 13 to 14 of years. So these are the changes which is taking place at the age of teenage, adolescent, and this time period of changes is known as puberty. Now, one by one, we are going to discuss about male reproductive organ. See, testes. Testes is present in a pouch called scrotal sac. Why it is present? Just now I have told you that it is an important question. It is present in the scrotum to maintain the low temperature. Okay? Testes is present in scrotum to maintain low temperature, which is required for production and survival of the sperm. Next is epididymis. See, it is a covered coiled tube, and it is a temporary storage for sperm, and it also acts as a path for the sperm. Vast difference originate from each testis, and sperm produced in testis are carried by vas deferens to a tube coming from urinary bladder. Okay, and seminal vesicle. It is a tightly coiled tube which secretes plasma, and its main function is to give nutrition to the sperm, and also it provides fluidity for the movement of sperm. Prostate glands, it secretes prostatic fluid, which keeps the sperm alive and help them to swim vigorously. So what will happen? Sperm will be able to move from one place to another, and it will be able to remain alive. Clear? And Cowper's gland, it is a pair of gland present below the prostate gland, and it secretes white viscous alkaline fluid. Okay, and only function of this is it acts as a lubricant. And penis is the external male genital organ. It releases sperm, and it is a common passage
for urine and sperm. In female reproductive organs, first is ovary. There are two ovaries present. These are oval in shaped, and it produces ova or egg. It is connected to the uterus by a ligament, and eggs produced by the ovaries are released in the abdominal cavity. Oviduct, it is a funnel shaped and open near the ovaries. So obviously, what will be its function? It will help in transmission of ova to the uterus. Okay, ovum reaches uterus through oviduct, and fertilization takes place in the oviduct. Oviduct is also known as fallopian tube. So if it is asked the site of fertilization, the site of fertilization will be the fallopian tube. And uterus, it is a hollow pear-shaped muscular structure where the development of fetus takes place, and function of uterus is menstruation, pregnancy, labor, development of fetus. And vagina is the lower part of the uterus, and which helps in ovulation. Along with that, it helps in coming out of, or we can say ejection of fetus. See, ovum is released in every 10 to 12 days after menstruation start. It reaches uterus on 14th day and remain there up to 16th day. Therefore, fertilization of an ovum takes place on 14 to 16 day of menstruation. And if sperm is not available, what will happen? The ovum will degenerate and it is rejected with next menstruation along with uterus lining. See, after fertilization, zygote is formed. How zygote is formed? It is formed after the fusion of sperm and ovum. That is during fertilization. And zygote fixes itself to the wall of uterus, which is richly supplied with blood. Now, zygote has a connection with the wall of uterus, and that is known as placenta. It is very important point. It is asked, what is placentation? What is the function of placenta? So, placentation means arrangement of zygote in the uterus, or we can say preparation, and that connection, vital connection with the uterus wall. And function of placenta is to give nutrition. It provides respiration, exchange of gases. Okay, so that is the function of uterus. And the development of fetus inside the uterus, it is known as gestation. And after the completion of gestation, the birth of fetus takes place, and that is known as parturation. Okay, now this is fertilization. But what will happen if fertilization does not take place? See, the shedding of inner cellular layer of uterus wall along with the bleeding from vagina will take place, and this whole process is known as menstruation, or we can say menstrual flow. The commencement, or we can say starting of menstruation at the age of puberty, is known as menarch. And it occurs on about 28th day of previous menstruation. It continues up to the age of 45 to 50 years. And after that, ovulation stops. And that phase is known as menopause. Clear? So after ovulation, either fertilization or menstruation will take place. This is all. So have for this session, watch the video properly, note down the points, and just clear out all the points and important terms I have told you. Thank you. Have a nice day.